Welcome back, everybody. So today we're going to be, okay, we're actually with the staffs of Silverman TV. Mm-hmm. So we're going to ask them a lot of questions we want to know about. Mm. So,
I'm suffering. How was it like being a child?
Okay, should I go first? Oh, yeah. I was very shy as a child.
Yeah.
But I had fun. I mean, lots of games. I played with toys. I watched a lot of TV. I just like literally enjoyed my childhood. Fun, lots of music. It was music, games, and books. I read a lot of books when I was a kid. So had like a fun childhood. Really fun childhood.
We all had fun childhood memories. For me, I really didn't like reading books. I'm sorry. But I liked watching a lot of stuff. So if you wanted me to learn stuff, I would rather you put it in visuals, like pictorial format of videos for me to watch. It sticks faster than me reading books.
Okay.
But initially, and eventually I now started reading Enid Blyton, and then from there it was easy for me to start enjoy the art of reading. I wasn't a toy person. I was a games person. So I really loved playing games. I loved playing football. I was in the cultural team. I liked playing lawn tennis as a kid. I was very bad, but I tried to, but I just enjoyed playing it. And you know that thing of that feeling of when they don't let you play and you're all angry and sulking. Yeah, that was me. Yeah. So, but it was fun though.
Mine was like lots of Annie Blighting, Sinclair, Mallory Towers, Famous Five, there's a whole lot. Then of course a lot of toys. Then I remember me going to school with my friends and we used to talk and we borrow books. It was fun. I didn't like going out because I was very shy. You know, but I remember this all those cultural dances. All those cultural dances, and I'll be the one in front dancing in my traditional attire. It was really, really good. And of course I grew up in Ibadan, so Ibadan was very quiet. So you go out and come back. It was just very nice. Childhood was fun. It was really fun too. I wish I could be a child all over again. Yeah, so I mean that was my childhood. It was great memories.
Wow, that was great.
Okay, me, I liked Enid Blyton books. I liked Mallory Towers. I've like finished all the series of them.
Oh, wow.
But I haven't read Sinclair, so I want to ask
you, read it.
What was your favorite Enid Blyton book?
Is it The Wishing? I can't remember. The Wishing something. It's been a long time.
The Wishing Chair.
The Wishing Chair. Yes, I think that's. It's a really long, but I read a whole lot of them. It's The Wishing Chair. There was a whole lot of. I can't remember right now. Then Famous Five. Five go to this. Five goes because you had all like 20 in one. So.
So what did you like? What did you want to be when you grew up?
When you were a child.
I actually wanted to be a dancer when I was a kid. Then. When I finished primary school, I was like, I was going to secondary school, and I was like, I want to go to a dance school. And my mom slapped the hell out of my mouth. And she's like, you keep quiet and go and read your book. What do you want to go and do with dancing? You know? So back then, that was, maybe now it's easier for you guys to always want to go for all of these things. But back then, it wasn't so easy. You know? And then even after secondary school, I still mentioned it. And the eyes she gave me was like, it's like that slap of that year is not, maybe you want to receive another one.
Yeah.
But that was really what I wanted to do. I wanted to dance. Mm. I loved dancing. Like, and in secondary school, I was like hot stepper for my class. I used to dance, do all the choreography and all of that. I don't know about now because it's not easy to move anymore.
Yeah.
But that was what I wanted to be when I was.
I wanted to be the first female Secretary General of the United Nations. I don't know where and how I had Then I wanted to win an Oscar.
All these people that used to sit in front.
I wanted to win an Oscar too. I wanted to be the first female Secretary General of the United Nations. I don't know where that dream came from, but I just knew that's what I wanted to be as a kid. But I didn't quite pan out because I never liked economics. That's like a later course that I didn't like anything that
but
was.
But me, I even liked economics. And you,
I wanted to be the
General
of the
United Nations.
It was Kofi Annan that I used to look back then and I'm like, there was no first female Secretary General of the United Nations, so I wanted, but I just don't know why. But I think I still just had love for entertainment because I remember watching lots of music videos. So maybe I kind of knew that I wanted to also
watch. I don't think to live in the right place.
But that was what it was. That was my dream. Then I wanted to win an Oscar too. First, I wanted to be the first female Nigerian to win an Oscar. I don't know if I had all those dreams, but it was just.
Wow, you were so matured as a child.
I used to write it in my book. I had a book. I write all the things I wanted to do as a kid, you know.
So do you guys have slum books?
Slum, yes.
Like where you put pictures of yourselves, you write diaries and stuff like that.
Movie,
my bestie, my this, my that, you know.
Not really.
Wow, we used to have that when we were kids. We had slum book where we'll take pictures, we'll use colored biros and pencils and just
to represent what we wrote.
Yeah, you know, it was more of a writing age because now we have the technology, but then we didn't really have all these things, so we had beautiful, colorful parts that we liked to write stuff in.
You have any questions?
The first time. Okay. You became a staff. How was it like? How did you feel?
Is it working here?
Yeah.
Well, I was surprised because, I mean, it was a different feel, like something that I'd not done. Like, I'd done this for a couple, but this was much different because it was TV. Yeah. And I didn't know how to enter into it.
Yeah.
But I think for me, it was just learning every day. So I was literally learning from people that I was hosting the show with every day and growing into it. I was nervous. I was like, hey, will I do this right when I went on TV? But of course, people were around me to support me, to help me, to guide me through the process. So it wasn't a one day's journey. I was always doing it every day. That's how you get better. And I was able to get better over the years. So it was not easy at first. So I was afraid. I'm not going to lie. That one, I was scared. But it's been a journey from then till now.
My experience working here first time when I started working here it was interesting, maybe because I was already doing presenting before coming here, but even when I started working there it was a bit interesting too because I looked at it as a game of pretense, you know. I used to do a lot of stage drama and all of that in secondary school. So I just looked at it as it's a game of pretend. Just be who the people want you to be for that moment. So it kind of like, you know, eased in gradually. So when I started working here, it was a bit easier than, you know, I thought. It was a bit also overwhelming because there were so many structures in place and things you need to do to achieve some certain things. So I also learned how to, at that beginning stage, I started learning how to follow protocol, you know, sending emails and all, because it was a big thing too. If you want to communicate officially, you have to send emails, and it wasn't something that I enjoyed doing. So I learned that as well. And so far, we are the better for it. I mean, look at us now.
Yeah.
Okay, so we'll be going on a break now, but what are your last words for kids watching?
The world is your oyster. I mean, just explore, be a child, don't be an adult, don't try to want to be anything more than an adult, because if I could go back to being a child, I would seize the opportunity, but I have to be an adult because I've got to pay bills. So just be a child, enjoy the moment, discover the world around you, listen to mommy and daddy, even though I know kids these days are very matured. When mommy says 10, they say like, mommy, I don't care, I don't do this, but please just enjoy being a kid and be nice. Don't be bullies, because some kids bully other kids. It's a big issue. So please, just be nice and show love to everyone around you.
Yeah, thank you.
For me, I think my last words would be, have it in your mind as a child that there is time for everything. Where you are now, if you're crushing on that boy, know that when you get like 3 years older, you'll see a very hot person, hotter than the boy you're crushing on right now. So don't be too crazy about it. It's a stage, okay? Because I remember the first crush I had, and when I look back now, and I'm like, no, this is last words for the kids. I'm not saying that. You know, so put it in your mind right now that there's a time for everything. It only gets better. It gets bigger with time. So enjoy every little moment you have with your family, with your childhood, with your friends. Okay, because you might never see them again for a long time.
Yes.
That's it.
So we'll be going on a break. And after the break, we're going to have the Budge Kids.